Hello, this is Master in 347, the Titan player for Okami HD. And last time, we started to make our way towards the city, but we had to make the bridge go lower the bridge first at the city checkpoint. And then unfortunately, where should we go? It was also cursed. Yep, even though Roach's gun is cursed, still grain in similar parts. But we got rid of that and had a quick look around. And we got a few new techniques as well. Preferably, the double jump. There's another new dojo now, which sells with you. Double jump is not optional, you need this for later on. The one which is optional, but I highly recommend you get, is also the champion digger. This allows you to dig through stuff like this, concrete. Now you're probably thinking bomb this part, can't, right? No, you can't. So you know champion digger, you can't get this. But the reason I backtracked to this spot specifically, because, well, you'll see soon enough. It's just plain awesome. Yep, it seems like a secret sanctuary of sorts, and there's a lot of prey to get here. And I mean a lot. These are the spots you definitely look out for. Look at that, nice swapping prey, it's beautiful. And we can also do the same for these trees here. And there's also a few clovers as well that we can do. So I do agree with the Wii remote, it is more accurate compared to maybe to the PS2. I just the PS2 / PS3 version, but I just like the fact that I don't have to worry about my Wii controller going weird on me. Oh, whoops. There we go. That's the other reason. And then to get these, pretty much treasures. Yeah, unfortunately, I didn't really do anything because off screen. The only thing I did off screen was pretty much feed some animals. But I didn't really do anything else because I was afraid I might not have enough money and stuff. But in this one, we get a stray bee. And I think I might be almost like the last one for this area too. I think I got all the treasures in here in the Tiger Pass now. This is why I want to go back here specifically. And there are going to be other areas like this as well, which you will be going to. Some of them will contain a lot of better stuff, not just treasure. More needs treasure trove. Yeah. So yep, this is exactly what we want to get a chance when we get to areas like this. But I'm going to see you guys back at the ryoshima coast, because we need to go past the city checkpoint first. So I'll see you guys then. Beam me up, Scotty. And we are back with the kick-ass music. Yeah, I feel a lot of pretty animals off screen and stuff. But importantly, there's a shortcut which actually you can do now. Which is a pretty big shortcut, I'm gonna show it to you guys quickly. There is this little tunnel around here. If you go through, you can go straight back to I guess a forest. Yeah, I accidentally did it off screen, but basically this part of the wall will blow up and you can actually go back here. So it's actually a shortcut. This is fantastic, seeing me going around too many places. So it's really useful to get from one place to the other. Just need to walk towards it and then that's it from this end. Oh man, I forgot it's clover. But yeah, with all these extra abilities we've got now, we're throwing a lot more praise. I mean a lot more. But since I maxed out my inks, I can start living on some other things. Let's start living now actually. I'm okay for the I think I might have upgraded my money. Actually, no, I will. With my pouch. I mean, purse. I think I'll upgrade it one more time. And that's what I actually need to upgrade for the rest of the game. But, yeah, that's it. But, you may notice there's a little wall around here. Well, we couldn't do it before, but now we can. Remember? Digging champ. This is actually pretty, different. Because when we do this, whoa, we get this weird dark mist. Yeah, what the heck's going on here? Well, you'll see soon enough, guys. Let's jump right in. Wait, what? That's right, guys. We get to fight the spider again. But this isn't the queen spider, it's the bandit spider. And we fight this person quite a few times, actually. There's only one huge difference. They have a few new attacks, and instead of doing this two times, you can do this up to three. And then you can hit her. But here's the thing. You can actually do this. That's right, with the fire. Yep. Because now we have Inferno. Oh, wait a minute. See, with Inferno, we can make this boss a whole lot easier. And she's dead! Yeah! I mean, like a piece of cake. But as long as you have Inferno now, these bosses are easy. So what? We have to do three times with Vine. Piece of cake! There! See? Effortless. But for our reward... Right through here... We get a sun fragment! And we've collected three, so our maximum health increases. Let's get out of here. And the thing is, we're actually going to be returning here later on for some of the toughest fights in the entire game. But I'm not going back there for a very long time. Yeah. You can fight these, like, I think it's like, these bunch, a whole bunch of demon gates in a row, and you find some really tough enemies. Or they're pretty much the same enemies you fought throughout the game, but they're much tougher. They have a lot more health and do a lot more damage. So don't even bother going back through there. Seriously, just save it for a lot later. We will be finding more of these cracks throughout the game, and I will be fighting the spiders. But yeah, I'm not going to spoil it for you guys. I'm just going to tell you guys right up. It's just the same enemy over and over again. It's just the spiders. It's exactly the same strategy. It's pathetic. But anyway, first of all, we're going to go in here and get some treasure. People offer us incense here. Wow, that's some statue. Somebody going to need it if it's going to last this much longer. Whoever owns this thing should be more careful. Let's see. There's an incense burner. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Yoink. It says that the priestess lives here, but it says she's gone to the city. Weirdo, she'd leave this place abandoned like this, but we'll be to question. Okay, the next treasure is actually around the back. But we need a moon for help here. So Gav from day to night thing. This makes finding buried treasure so much easier. Let's see. There we go. Whoa! What was that? Wow, that's one odd technical glitch. Jeez. It was a camera angle. It was a camera angle. That was the problem. This. Weird. Oh. Anyway. Let's get some more of this treasure here. But yeah, I didn't want to do anything in the dojo because I want to save some money from getting it in the city. And if that's the case, I'll probably just do it when I'm outside. Off screen anyway, I can do it later. There's no point doing everything now. Especially at risk of let's see. If there's some treasure around here. But can we get it now? Oh, whoops. Yeah, I said there's some treasure underwater, so I bet it's just like before that stray bead. But, can I get this now? Ah, there they are! You see the clams? That's them. Let's have a look. Can I get this now or later? I don't want to be gobbled up by that, dragon. Yeah, I'm not going to risk it. I'm going to save first, because I don't remember. It's not an instant kill, but I think I don't want it affecting anything in particular. No, no, there's no dragon here at all. Excellent! Oh my goodness, no, it's just me. But yeah, remember, just like all the other shells, what you need to do is just power slash. I'm not really sure if they're seashells or clams or whatever, I don't really care. But just power slash him, and there we go. There should be a three here. So let's see, that's one, that's two. There we go, there's the third one. All the way over there. Go. Ah, and there's our way back up. Up we go. There we go. Some light there. Okay, now I'm going to get some treasure on the other side, right here. There we go, down here specifically. Let's see. I'll get that clover. Well, not yet anyway. Nope. Let's have a look, see. Yep, they're both in the water somewhere. I probably have to go out a bit more to see to have it seen where they are. Let's have a look. Yeah, the daughters isn't really that great here. It's pretty annoying in trying to find certain items. Aha! Yeah, see? I'm not really sure why they can fix the draw distance in this game, it's quite odd. There we go. Oh, damn it. There we go. That speeds. And one over here. Is a mermaid coin. Nice. Wait for backtracking. Eventually, we won't ever need to have new mermaid coins. But that may be for quite a while yet. So I'm probably not going to buy any more now, because don't need to buy too many of them. Because again, later on, certain tech, but you see soon enough. Oh, and here's that shell right here. I think you really only can slash him because they're in the sea, so What else are you supposed to do? Okay, now for that sunken ship. Now, we're not going inside a ship, we're going on top of it. Remember to have those lily pads at the ready. Well, I guess we could jump up there if we wanted to. I don't think there's anything up there now. Well, there's nothing up there, so there's no point going up there at the moment. Should get those lily pads out. Yeah. There is actually some treasure in here too. There's other treasures as well, but unfortunately we're going to get those till later. So we're only getting the ones at the top. Here we go. So yeah, it looks like there's nothing here specifically, but there is. What a sorry sight. I bet it was one sweet ship in its heyday. It could have been carrying lots of stuff aboard. But how are we going to get in without drowning? True. There is a way to get hit here. Basically, we need to jump up somewhere. Let's have a look. Oh, here we go. Found it. Yeah, it was this. Oof. Come on. Here we go. Yep, need to walk up this... beam. Yeah, because we seem to slip off all the others. And with that, we get a stray bead. And here... a golden peach. So, worth your time. Very worth your time. I'm gonna stick with daytime for a while. Unless I'm looking for berry treasure. But yeah, this is why I wanted to glimpse over Ryoshima Coast in the last part. Because I wanted to get the side quest stuff out of the way, so that way I can focus solely on looking for treasure. Here we go. Nice. Here we go. Oh. I think there's another shell around here somewhere. Yep, here we are. Sweet. And here's another one. Like there, this isn't nearly enough. There are still a ton more treasures out there. Like, you can go throughout the ocean, but there's no point because, well, I don't think we can because, well, you heard about that sea dragon business and, yeah, you have nothing to do with that thing. So, no way. God, I don't want to overwhelm me with all this treasure, even if we could go out there. Plus, it'd be really time consuming. It's actually a quicker way of getting around to these parts later on. So, yeah, I don't want to do that. Hmm, like there's some berry treasure around here. Time for the moon to help us out. Here we go. Yeah, getting treasure now is so much easier with the power of the moon. Well, berry treasure anyway. I said there was one around here somewhere. There we go. Come to Papa. Mm-mm. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Okay, now there is actually a treasure around this part here. And let's see. Yep, a clam and a clover. Nice. So I'm gonna make a ton of money off all these things. Okay. Now we have to go all the way to this part here. To use sprout water. It's the only way to get up on this part. See? All the way there. We need to go to this very top part anyway, because there's actually a treasure here. Have any of you guys been watching the Final Fantasy 15 anime series, Brotherhood? Yes, yeah, I've been watching it, and I've been enjoying it quite a lot. Especially the backstories of all the characters and stuff, and it really gets me investing them into the... Oh, feed? That's what I love about you guys. Finally, we can actually use the fist. Yeah. Pretty funny, though. So here is a dragonfly bead. Nice. Very nice indeed. And for the moment, there's only one more treasure we need to get. And then we're done here for the time being. So, yep. There we go. But yes, we're finally done this place for now. There's still a lot more stuff around here. Actually, there's a treasure right around here. Yep. Whoa. What is that stuff? Yeah, you can actually get a view of the city at one part. Wait a minute. It said you can get a view from up here. Yeah, see? Well, if you can tell, it's full of that horrible green mist. Whatever the hell it is. Let's head on in. Cyan City. Commoners quarters. Huh? What the? I thought the big city would be a happening place. What's up with this funky looking mist? It looks jammed like hazardous to your health. I wonder if people actually live normal lives with nasty stuff. And this place is hazardous. I'll show you. See? I can't bloom any of the trees because of this place. Well, because of this weird mist. But this is why I wanted to upgrade my purse. Right here. Oh, this is terrible. The water dragon is causing so much trouble out in the sea. It's got to the point where I can't produce any goods to sell. There used to be tons of fish boat in Wyoming and here in the city. The water dragon's antics have scared them all away. The price of fresh fish has gone through the roof. Why is it, Pooch? Been sent to do the shopping, have you? I don't have much of a sale, but feel free to take a look. So, make sure you buy all of these things. These are for side quests and stuff later on. So, buy this. That's actually an Easter egg from Resident Evil. Because when you combine the red herb and the green herb, and you combine them to make it look like that, so it's like herbal medicine. So that's pretty cool. So that's why I wanted to save it for that. Actually, I can sell a few things here. Oh, whoops. Wow. Four of them. That was because of that place. There's actually two shops here. That's all the side quest stuff, which you definitely want to get. But here... Oh there, Mutt. What are you doing out in this mist like this? Now is hardly a time to be wandering around, Cyan. Not since the mist arrived so suddenly. The curse zone's appearance hasn't helped matters either. Queen Amika's gone and shut herself up in her palace, and everyone else is hiding out inside their homes. Shouldn't it be a job of our leader to help us through this? Anyway, business is slow to say the least. If you've been sent to do shopping, then go over it. Yep, you can actually buy a new weapon here, 7 Strike. Glaive whose edge is divided into 7 parts, grants ink bullet power, and it costs 100,000. So yeah, this is why I wanted to get this, so I can have this weapon instead. Some gold dust, actually I'll get those too. So yeah, I didn't get this glaive for too long. Maybe you have an upgraded weapon, so... And now I notice there's the sub-weapon as well. The sub-weapon during battle, you can actually like do you can do a special aerial attack which targets enemies from a long distance, so it's pretty sweet actually. I have some gold dust, so let's power up this weapon. There we go. Plus, this looks so badass. Look at that. That is such a cool ass sword. But yeah, a lot of people here are suffering. But there is one thing we are going to do while it looks like this. Basically makes it easy to get certain treasure now while it's in this state. You notice that in below the ground, there's actually no water either. Well, there's a lot of treasure underneath here. But it'd be much annoying to get if it's just full of water. So we're going to go back and get that in a bit. No, actually, no, we'll do it now. We'll do it now. Get a double jump, so we can get out of here. Basically, we can, because there's no water here, we can easily get all this treasure. Ooh, and a stray bead? Nice. Very nice indeed. So, what we're going to do is we're going to run around here for a bit and get all this nice treasure. This is the only good thing about the poison mist. Makes it easy to get all this stuff. Otherwise, eventually, spoiler alert, this is going to be full of water again. We don't have to use power stash and all of this stuff here. Ooh, he doesn't look good at all. Oh, what's going on? I don't know what came over me. I had this incredible sudden pain, and now I'm stuck here like this, and I can't move an inch. I'm so useless. If I don't get to work on the canal with the boss, we won't be able to get the water flowing again. Well, what am I going to do? Oh man, this looks bad, Army. Yeah, that's basically where about the canal, but we're not going to do that just yet. I'm looking around this part and get all of the treasure here, which is on this bed floor. Again, it says you have to do it later when the water eventually comes back. So it's best to do this now. There we go. Ooh, speaking of which. Oh, I thought I had enough to upgrade my purse again. There we go. Again, I'm getting all of this now, so I'm going to do it later. There we go. And that's it for that section. As you can see, everyone isn't feeling too well. Everyone is suffering pretty badly here. There's treasure around here. I didn't see it. Oh. I can't get those ones yet. All right. But I didn't worry about the treasure outside. It was the treasure in the water I wanted to focus on. So make sure you get all those now to save you having to get the rest later while the water's up. Again, this makes it easier. I can get the rest later on. I just wanted to focus on ones in the water. Ow, ow, ow. I've been under the water for a while now. Lately the pain's so bad I can see it's up and I'm out and about. Nurses, I don't have time for this. Ow, ow, ow. Stop staring at me, mutt. This mist does seem to make you feel sick and depressed. Ever heard of anything like that before, Army? I was traveling the country to affect my martial arts. And when I arrived here in Cyan City, I suddenly started to feel ill. I heard rumors of all the Queen Emiko's holy power is incredible. Sure, this can't be her doing. This mist across the city is suspicious too, but I won't let it get the better of me. Nothing gets the better of me. I knew it, Army. It's an ordinary mist. I mean, it's all over the city and won't go away. It's downright unnatural. Seeing there's still some people who are unaffected, but who knows what will happen if this continues a few more days. Yep, it is not looking good. City's bigwigs live across the bridge ahead. That area is crammed full of awesome palaces. One of them belongs to Queen Emiko, ruler of Nippon. You can tell because it's really huge. I know what she's like, but I'm not sure I like her. I mean, she doesn't seem to be doing anything about this mist. Plus, I make it a point to never trust queens and the like anyway. tiny aristocratic quarter. Ah, great. The bridge is out? Who are you? Alright, I'm back. Yeah. There's a reason I wanted the ports for a while. Because this guy. Where did all the water go? Oh, hello, Pooch. Thinking about crossing Gojo Bridge? Well, think again. This bridge is a very special contraption. With one command, I can make it passable and another impassable. But there's a reason why I can't operate right now. Oh? Really? Stop pressing me! I can't make the bridge passable right now. At least not until the lake's water is restored, and I get that elusive item. Elusive item, eh? So the only way to get him past the bridge is to help him release the item. Alright, let's do it. Now we're going to restore the water. So go around here. Keep out, digging for water source. The digging's a canal here? Pretty interesting, don't you think, Army? Digging. You probably guess what's gonna happen next, guys. And it's pretty I'm just gonna tell you right now. It's another digging game. Another digging game. Oh wow. Who's that? God, I feel like my whole body is being choked by something. I've been feeling rough ever since that curse appeared. Many are even worse off than me, since I've come to illness. Oh, our poor city. What's happening to us? Curse that confounded water dragon causing so much commotion. How can a god of the sea be ruling in peace like this? I bet the dragon is to blame for the state of this canal too. All that fuss has caused the lake to plug itself up. That's a common to Naguri. Hey, Ami, looks like there's trouble over here too. See, this whole city is a complete mess. Oh, did you come here for a drink or water bowl? I'm afraid it's completely dried up. This canal is a really important source of water for us. That's why I'm digging a hole to see if I can tap into it again. So many people are sick now that there's hardly anyone to help out. In fact, I'm the only one left. One dirty carpenter. But I'm determined to not give up. You get quite fit doing my job. Now I can rip the benefits. I built almost everything you see here in Soem, you know. So there's nothing I don't know about the place. Wanna know where the key to this water source lies? It lies in Lake Biwa's drain plug. You're certainly seen to this in Wellfoot Beach. Maybe I should tell you about the Lake Biwa's plug then. Soem City is flowing in the middle of Lake Biwa. The water flow will fill the canal around the city, but the water dragon antics have made the plug seal up. No wonder the canal is dried up. And that's why we're in this sorry state now. I'm sure that the plug is located beneath the area. If I can dig my way to it, the water should come gushing out. It's pretty exciting, don't you think? If you think so, then maybe you could help me out. And this isn't optional. We have to do this. Okay, fine. It's a shame Wolf is going to only answer with their eyes. Still, it doesn't matter what you are if you're willing to help. Now listen carefully while I explain what you have to do. Like I told you, Lake Biwa's plug is right below us here. I'll concentrate all my efforts to find you. All you need to do is use those claws to get digging. I'll use the hole to dig you to get to the plug. And when I reach it, I'll give it a good whack and open it up. When the water comes out, you might need to give me a hand. So do you understand what you have to do? Yes! That looks like yes to me. It's time for Wolf and Human to pull their energy together. Let's get going! Just like before, after digging away to the bottom. No. There we go. We're almost there. Come on. You can make it. There. Oh, right, also another thing. If you want to make him run or anything, you can literally draw a circle around him. But I can't do that at the moment. Okay, we made it to the bottom. Yes! Dig, 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 dig! Again, I made that look easy because I knew where I was going. If you don't, it may take you a few tries. There! That's one problem solved. Oh, wolf. Look at this wonderful wolf in Lake Biwa. Soem has had its fair share of hardships lately. The water dragons on the rampage and the strange races all over, they matter not what tribes present themselves to us. We've sold them one by one. We will emerge unscathed. I suppose my work here is done for now. Thanks, Wolf. You did a good job. Thank you for the praise. Alright. But that guy says it's true. We have plenty of a lot of problems, but they can be solved if we tackle them one at a time. Doing it all at once is crazy. Hmm? Oh, that's night time. It's hard to tell though because of the mist. Yeah, let's make a day. Okay. Well, that's one problem. But next we need to get this bridge up. Here we go. That's the time is near. Benkai, the fisherman, Mum, should lay claim to his 1,000th sword. And he is actually based on mythology. Wandering warrior monk, Benkai. Seto Musahibo Benkai, properly called Benkai, was a Soke, the Sohe, warrior monk, who served Minamoto no Yoshitsune, aka Ishu Waka, which is related to Waka here. He is commonly depicted as a huge man of great strength and loyalty, and is one of the favorite subjects of Japanese folklore. His life has been embellished and distorted by kabuki and no drama. The truth cannot be distinguished from legend. Benkai Seto posted himself as Gojo Bridge in Kyoto, where he obtained a sword from every battle swordsman. After obtaining 999 swords, he challenged Ishiwaka for his 1,000th sword. After losing the battle, he became a retainer for Ishiwaka. Benkai served Ishiwaka very well. He eventually died protecting Ishiwaka when he was surrounded by enemies. Legend recounts how Benkai, pierced by arrows, fought to the bloody end and died standing on his feet. So he's pretty awesome. I've traveled far and wide, challenging master swordsmen, and 999 swords have I claimed by my own hands. But now that I've defeated all who would dare challenge me, that sword needed me. I need but one more to make 1,000, and thus, aimlessly, I have won it. That is until a legend draws me to Cyan City. It said the living sword lies in the depths of Lake Bura. Have you heard legend about Lake Bura? Even I could barely believe it when I first heard. But they say a living sword swims freely about these waters. If true, it would make a fitting addition to my 1,000th sword. This bridge is a very special contraption. With one command, I can make it passable and another impassable. As you can see, it makes for a fine place to fish. It grieves me to cut off access to the city, but I'm afraid this bridge shall stay this way while I fish for the living sword. Of course, this may be easier said than done. This is no mere fish trip for me. This is a true battle of the living sword. I must therefore arm myself with a white weapon. That fishing rod over the two to the town would be perfect. Yep, so make sure you buy that fishing rod. Said the purest of white, like new fallen snow. There is no chance of victory about that one. Alas, it would appear that I cannot afford it. Oh, what am I to do? That's the blinding snow. Yep, make sure you buy it. That is an option, you need it. The rod from tool dealer. With that fine rod, I would at last have a chance against a living sword. Be a good dog, give it to me here. Yep. Hand it over. Ooh, happy day. I have never fished before, but I should not be much different from a good sword fight. Now to catch the 1,000th sword. I should engage in mortal combat with the elusive living sword. I've been holding my wand over this wall for some time. However, the living sword has yet to bite. But you know what they say, patience is a virtue. I shall sit here as long as it takes. Amy? Hoodhead here has never gotten letters across this lake. Tell him some of your angling magic of yours. Show him how you do it. Fish that living sword out of this lake. Yep. Bah. Hoodhead sure is a handful. I wonder if there really is such a thing as a living sword anyway. It's the fishing game again. Just like before, so I don't mean to explain anything. Okay, Amy, you got the basic idea, right? So you blah blah blah, we know. Draw the line. I'm not going to explain to you guys again, because we've done this like 2 times now. So just like before, yep, you know. If he's in the red, then he starts losing health. Just pull in the opposite direction via analog stick again. Then do this, do the action command with the button, and you get a fish. Smelt, okay. It's just like before, we need a fish. 2 small fish first, before we get access to a bigger one. Get me, no! Seriously, they repeat the same thing like 3 times that you see. Killifish. Okay. There he is. Oh, whoops. And get away from me, blah blah blah, you know. Oop, this one's a bit tougher. He likes his directions a lot more often. No, no, come on. No. Yep, and just like the other big fish, it's gonna take more than one slash to take him down. Come on. Come on. Three? Of course it's gonna take three. No. 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 Don't care of losing health, as long as I can get ya. Got ya! You put, cut this fish, the living sword. The gods be praised. At last I fulfilled my dream. So, that is a living sword? That is what I've been pursuing all this time? Don't take it so hard. I mean, that was one big cutlass fish. And a cutlass is a kind of sword, isn't it? Plus, what are the odds of catching an ocean fish in a lake? Spare me no such solace. But enough about that. Our monk never goes back on his word. I shall make this jigsaw bridge passable once more. Yeah, that's all we had to do. Yeah, to make sure you buy... Whoa! Whoa, stop, Amy. I thought this mist was coming from the lake or mountains. So what's that stuff rising with the Imperial Palace? Just keep going, Furball. Ah, no, not him again. Well, well, look at what the cat dragged in. What took you so long, Machiri? Ah, not you again! No, you can't fool us. We're not gonna forget what you did to us back in the Wretched's cave. And why did you keep popping up everywhere anyway? What are you up to this time? Excuse me, Ma? I have no time for following around. You see, I'm busy looking for something. But some prophet you are. Shouldn't you already know where to look? Well, maybe look isn't the right word. I already know where it is, it's just... Getting there is proving to be quite a bit of a problem. Suffice it to say, I want it quick and easy. Quick and easy? Wait a sec. Don't tell me you're behind this funky mist. Is this part of a plan to conquer the city or take over the world? You're always up to no good, so I won't be surprised. The world? Not bad, my little bouncing friend. You're only half wrong. I seek the other world. I desire a path to the heavens. A path to the heavens? Oh, stop beating around the bush and let us know what is on your mind. This path concerns you too, naturally. Eh? What do you mean by that? This city is quite in a bad state, is it not? Especially this ghastly mist that torments its people. You think we're stupid? Bristly white fruit, you pretty boy. Yeah, we got you all figured out. This funky mist and your so-called path to the heaven, you're in coach to the Queen Hemiko. The journey of a thousand miles means every single step. So just take it step by step. You must first deal with the mist. It's slowly but surely killing the people of this city. Wait too long? It's au revoir. The damage will already be done. Why, you talk about it like it's something else's problem. You're behind it all. Admit it already. Even if I was, what's good would come out of it arguing about it here? We think you should be doing something about the mist now. How about a tip? This time, instead of a prophecy, goes through the hole in the wall, little ones. Let me put it this way. Even the most solid defense has a tiny gap like the eye of a needle. Or something like that. Understand, Machiri? Yeah, he just repeats himself. Come on, Okami. I'm sick of talking to this guy. Yep, it looks like we made some progress today. He managed to make it across, he managed to get a lot more treasure in the coast. Got this nice looking sword. And we managed to make it across the bridge after bringing back this city's water. And unfortunately we got to visit Waka again. Yippee. But I think we're going to end it off here. Next time, we're going to go further in the aristocrat quarter of Cyan City and try to find out what the heck's going on with this mist. I mean, why is it going from the palace? Well, we won't find out about that for a while, but hopefully you might find a way to get into that ship. But with that, it's Mastering 347. Game Titan RPG the Platformer. Stay classy.